Hi, and welcome to the Golden Years of Hollywood. Well, today I want to talk about one of the zaniest and funniest films from the 1930s. It's The Marx Brothers and A Night at the Opera. The Marx Brothers started their film career with Paramount Pictures in 1929 with The Coconuts, which was a filmed version of their famous play. Now, over the next 4 years at Paramount, the boys made other classic films like Animal Crackers, Monkey Business, Horse Feathers, and Duck Soup. But it was in 1935 that Irving Thalberg from MGM was able to secure the brothers, minus Zeppo, the fourth member of the team, for a Class 1 big budget production. Now, MGM had more money to throw around than Paramount, so it was a step up in production value, but it involved more development in the routines that would be featured in the film. So Thalberg sent the three Marx Brothers, along with co-star Alan Jones, out on the road to tour various theatres, and here they were able to test which jokes and situations got the best laughs, which Alan Jones now recalls in this interview that I conducted with him back in 1988.
Well, it was quite an experience. I had never worked with comedians before, but I had a chance to get to know them because Thalberg sent us out on the road to try out the gags in a picture house. We played four shows a day and the gags were clocked, and if they didn't run a certain length of time, we had new gags the next show. We had four shows a day. After 2 weeks, we finally had it ironed out, went back to the studio, and we started the picture. But going to the theater from the hotel, I was sure I was going to be thrown in jail, because walking along, Harper would see these lovely girls coming toward us, and he'd leave us and run like mad and jump on them and throw his legs around them. And
so it wasn't just a stage act, it was in real life too.
They just, anything that they were spontaneous.
All right, bring them in. Say, there's a slight misunderstanding here. I said the girls had to work fast, not your friend.
He's still asleep.
You know, he does better asleep than I do awake.
Now, the story is not the driving theme of this film. The thin plot involves Groucho, as an agent, trying to sell the world's greatest tenor, played by Alan Jones, to the heads of the New York Opera Company. The lovely Kitty Carlisle is the love interest for Alan Jones, but was not known as a singer. Now, the initial plan was for her voice to be dubbed by a professional opera singer, but Kitty insisted that her voice be used. And with the help of Alan Jones and the Marx Brothers, Irving Thalberg finally relented and allowed her own voice to be used. And look, to be honest, in my mind, this was a good decision, as she really has a lovely voice and was well suited to Alan Jones, especially when they feature the film's big hit song, Alone. But the music in the opera is really just a sideline in this film. It's all about the Marx Brothers just dancing around from scene to scene, causing as much mayhem as possible. Groucho's constantly trying to woo the affections of Margaret Dumont, all the while throwing insults her way. Now, Chico and Harpo are doing everything possible to cause chaos until the heads of the opera company finally come to their senses and sign up the talents of Alan Jones and Kitty Carlisle. Now, as much as the film is regarded as a classic today, it almost wasn't made. You see, MGM head Louis B. Mayer hated the Marx Brothers, and it was only Irving Thalberg that was able to get them signed and the film approved. In fact, at one point during production, Louis B. Mayer asked Groucho how the picture was going, to which Groucho replied, "What business is that of yours?" Now, you can imagine how furious that made Mayer, the head of the studio. But the boys really were basically out of control. They were grabbing people as they entered the executive building and stripping them of their pants or shirts. And when Thalberg went into his office, he found it full of smoke and then saw the Marx brothers, they were overcooking sausages in his fireplace. Well, Thalberg laughed at this and all the antics of the brothers, but Mayer couldn't stand them or their comedy, even though A Night at the Opera ended up making more than $3 million profit for the studio. Well, A Night at the Opera is regarded today as possibly the best of the Marx Brothers films and has a prime place amongst the classic films from the golden years of Hollywood. I'm David Duncan. I'll see you next time.